Pacific Gas and Electric said on Monday that it would seek bankruptcy protection as the only viable option as the giant California utility faces millions of dollars in liability claims from 2 years of deadly wildfires. The company's troubles pose a challenge to the state's elected officials and regulators, who will ultimately decide whether part of the solution will be raising already high electricity rates. The problems could also make it harder to achieve California's ambitious goals for renewable energy. Experts said PG&E's predicament could be an early indicator of a wider economic toll from climate change, which is making wildfires more frequent and destructive. At the same time, the financial straits could handicap the utility's ability to step up the kind of preventive measures it has been faulted for neglecting, like trimming trees and brush around power lines and transformers. For Governor Gavin Newsom, who took office last week, the bankruptcy disrupts an agenda that until now had focused on early childhood education, paid parental leave and the expansion of the state's health care program to cover more undocumented residents. Mr. Newsom said Monday that he had been in constant contact throughout the week and over the weekend with the company and regulators. Everyone's immediate focus is, rightfully, on ensuring Californians have continuous, reliable and safe electric and gas service, he said. Fire investigators determined PG&E to be the cause of at least 17 of 21 major Northern California fires in 2017. It is also suspected in some of the 2018 wildfires that have been described as the worst in state history, including one that killed at least 86 people and destroyed the town of Paradise.